My name is Hans Grönlund. I work as a scientist at Karolinska Institutet at the Department of Clinical Neuroscience.
What is your main research topic, or what are your main research topics?
My main research topics is allergy. I have been working with allergy for the last 35 years, lately most pet allergens and how to diagnose, how to treat patients with pet allergy. My role is to be a group leader. I have about 10 people who are doing research in a translational way. My research group is called Therapeutic Immune Design. So I design therapeutics, biomolecular molecules that will play with the immune system in such a way that you will cure patients, whether it's cancer or multiple sclerosis or allergy.
Why are you so passionate about allergies? What is so special?
The thing with pet allergy is that it's a very social disease. So you cannot just say that it is something that is there out in the society. It will affect your neighbors, it will affect your classmates, it will affect your mother and father, and also who you meet.
And what are the biggest issues you wanted to address in your research?
I want to cure the population. And I actually want to cure them from not getting allergy at all.
Is this possible?
Yes.
And how?
Well, this is what we have learned lately, that by introduction very early on in life, in a smart way, you can skew the immune system in such a way that you will not encounter the or react to the allergen later on in life.
How do you see the future of allergy treatments?
For me, it would be the ideal would be to treat very early on children that would not get allergy at all. That would be the main topic. Otherwise, we have devised together with other groups a way to introduce allergens in small amounts to induce tolerance. So that is the, in a way, a better way than has been today, but we're refining that at the moment.
What is new in this treatment?
We try to make a treatment with 3 to 4 injections. These 3 to 4 injections should not be felt by the patient, but they still should be very effective. And there is very great hope for that. We have shown that this is, in principle, possible.
What do we need, actually?
We need resources. We need funding. We know how to do it. We have the vaccine on the shelf, but we will also need someone to finance this. And this is the first trip is about 4 million euros. And then all the way to the patient, perhaps the double of that sum. And that is what is needed. In Sweden, it is a very small amount per person, actually.
What would you change tomorrow?
I would like the funding bodies, the authorities, to realize that the need of the people is to be cured, and that they, both for the sake of job and for health, where we try to struggle, this Death Valley March is something prohibitive for scientists. If you go there, you're very likely to be dried out and not come back to research again. So you should help those scientists who really want to contribute to society. Good research need resources and it needs know-how. It depends on what you want to do with research. If you want to just add information about how a biological body functions, then that is fine. And we should know more about that. If you want, on the other hand, to make life better for healthcare and society, then you need a set of steps and rules that will help you to create jobs, to make better living, better quality of life. And that is a funding possibility. So in my mind, you should try to focus also resources into this translational research. That would make my life completely different.
What does good research need?
I do not necessarily think that we need more ideas. What we need is ideas that are put into reality, to they should be tried. And that is the problem. A good researcher needs the help to bring his research, in my mind, to the patient, to be translational. This is the really big difficulty. How do you take a curative treatment all the way through good manufacturing practice, toxicology, IMPD, ethical permissions, medical product agency? That is a very expensive trip. And as a scientist, you cannot do that without help.
What motivates you?
What motivates me is to leave a better world after me. This is my great motivation. Also, I enjoy this life tremendously. I come to work every day full of energy. I have so many good collaborators. They are all there and we work together. It is such a fun way of living.
And is there a day in your research life that you remember in a special way?
In a special way? Well, yes, when I get funding to do a new project that really made it. That is, I don't, you know, the thing is, it is so incremental. It is always a little bit step ahead. So these huge moments, they are sort of like a continuum. Each day is a huge moment.
Great.
It is.
What is the most important lesson that you have learned from your research or from being a researcher?
To be a researcher is to be able to communicate with people from all over the world. And you realize that people are basically the same. There is no difference between people.
What kind of society do you dream of?
Honestly, I think that I dream of a society where money is not the driving force, but actually love between people. You should be able to help people, other people. You should be able to be compassionate about other people and see their how they are as people, as persons. It is not a matter of how you are acting, but how you hug people. This is sort of a very much a passionate thing. People should enjoy each other.
Thank you very much, Hans.
Thank you.